Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question was sent in by someone who wanted to figure out how to duplicate one of the charts from our charting challenge. So I'm here at MrExcel.com, and along the left-hand navigation, I'm going to choose Challenge of the Month, and then choose Past Challenges, and then the Innovative Chart Challenge from November-December. Let me scroll down here. And they were interested in this chart sent in by Jerome Sullivan that shows budget versus expenditure, and the columns are actually right on top of each other. You can see the budget numbers in white and the actual expenditures in red. Let's see if we can create this chart in Excel. It's actually pretty tricky to do. I set up my data series here with the four quarters and a column for budget and a column for actual. I'll choose that whole data set, use Insert, Chart, and say that I want a clustered column chart. I don't want them stacked on top of each other. Click Finish. And initially I get not the correct effect. The columns are next to each other instead of on top of each other. It turns out the trick is very similar to the trick from Monday. I want to choose the second series, Format Data Series, and say that it should be plotted on the secondary axis. This actually forces Excel to plot the columns right on top of each other. Now luckily here I have one series where budget was larger than actual, and I'm able to click on that bar to select the budget series. Right click and choose Format Data Series, and then go to the Options tab. Here I want to change the gap width. By making the gap between the bars smaller, I'll actually make each bar wider. So I'll change this from 150 maybe back to 70, and you can see in the preview there it sort of works. We'll click OK. All right, and now we can see the two bars, but we're not done yet. There's a very dangerous thing that's been set up here because we have now plotted each column on a different axis. Excel has chosen the left axis to run from 23,500 to 28,000, and the right axis to run from 0 to 35,000. We need to customize both of these to make sure that they are the exact same number. I like the 0 to 35,000, so I'm going to go over to the left axis, right click, choose Format Axis, and on the Scale tab, uncheck the auto box, say that I want it to start at 0, uncheck the maximum, say that I want it to go to 35,000. Click OK, and now we have both scales set up exactly identical. To change the colors, fairly easy to do. Click on the Expense tab, choose Format Data Series, change the color to white, click OK, click on one of the actual columns, right click, Format Data Series, change the color to red, click OK. Now in Jerome's chart, he actually made the right numbers be red to indicate that they were actuals. In my opinion, we can actually get rid of these right-hand numbers once we know that we've set both axes up to be the exact same scale. So I'm going to right-click, Format Axis. On the Scale tab, I'm going to turn off the automatic, make sure that it goes from 0 to 35,000. And then on the Patterns tab, go to Tick Mark Labels and say None, click OK. And now we've completely eliminated those numbers along the right-hand side. There you have it, how to create a chart where the two columns are on top of each other, but one column is wider than the other so you can see it behind. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.